lies not in his weaponry. In the end, it lies in his mind. And what the world requires, I think, then, in this 22nd year of our atomic age, is not a new race towards armament. What it requires today is a race towards reasonableness. And I think we'd better all run that race, not only we, the administrators, but we, the people.
Those retiring from our highest levels of government, including those of our military establishment, are countering and pushing back on a weapons industry out of step, out of any constructive purpose. Former Senator Sam Nunn, chair of the Armed Services, said the nuclear weapons states have a very hard time thinking about national security without nuclear weapons. The words are there. What is missing is execution. What is missing is presidential focus. What is missing is an organization that is held accountable. Most of the efforts disappear at the third and fourth levels of bureaucracies without the people at the top paying a lot of attention. That has to change. Nunn, along with Secretaries of State George Shultz, Henry Kissinger, and Secretary of Defense William Perry, joined together in recent years to write several op-eds in the Wall Street Journal, proclaiming, "The end of the Cold War made the doctrine of deterrence obsolete. Reliance on nuclear weapons for this purpose is becoming increasingly hazardous and decreasingly effective." Their vision shocked experts in the doctrine of deterrence. Mikhail Gorbachev wrote in 2007, quote, "It's becoming clear that nuclear weapons are no longer a means of achieving security. In fact, with every passing year, they make our security more precarious." On their board, General Eugene Habinger, former Commander-in-Chief to the U.S. Strategic Command. A few of the experienced, highest-level officials that have joined in public support of their call. As long as there's been war, deterrence and war strategy were identical. Mutually assured destruction was based essentially on a bipolar world. The Cold War is 20 years behind us. Nuclear weapons increase the danger of an accidental or unauthorized use, or even a deliberate nuclear exchange. With the spread of nuclear materials and know-how, and when a growing number of nuclear adversaries confront multiple perceived threats, the risk that deterrence will fail and that nuclear weapons will be used increases dramatically. It is clear that the U.S. and Russia, having led the nuclear buildup for decades, must lead the build down. Global leaders owe it to their publics to eliminate these risks. We endorse setting the goal and the reassertion of a world free of nuclear weapons. Achieving that would be consistent with America's moral heritage. Without the vision of moving towards zero, we will not find the essential cooperation required to stop our downward spiral. We need a new dialogue.